From the iX, the i7, the XM, and then to the Neue Klasse, BMW's design language has changed over the time. However, the Neue Klasse has its roots in the original Neue Klasse 1500 back in 1962, the same car that saved BMW from near bankruptcy. This is the BMW Vision Neue Klasse and the Vision Neue Klasse X. Even with my not so good German, I can tell that Neue Klasse means new class, which is the newest addition to BMW's new design language. But before now, we've seen different lineups from BMW and now the Neue Klasse. And whatever you feel about the BMW's new design approach, this is a hard reset. We've seen Jaguar's complete design language, which is pretty amazing if you ask me. And now BMW is connecting to the realm of sport activity vehicles, SAV, like they call it. According to Frank Weber, a member of the board of management at BMW, the BMW of the future will have four new super brains, high-performance computers working smartly together on what, up until now, was processed separately. These two new cars borrow inspiration from BMW's Vision Circular and the High Vision D concept, which set the path towards complete electrification and sustainability. And BMW said the Neue Klasse will be based on three principles, which are electrification, digitalization, and circularity. Some changes are quite noticeable, especially with the Neue Klasse X. There is a lower belt line which saves weight and offers the possibilities of good eyesight, especially if you have an average height. And again, as you can see, there are significantly large windows and a panoramic glass roof which creates a sense of space. The frontal appearance with a smaller and interactive grille or kidney grille, and also the new headlights look different from the traditional way BMW designed its frontal part with a large kidney grille. Around the kidney grille, you notice there are no more chromes, which are not only environmentally unfriendly but also difficult to produce. Now you have light in place of the chrome, and if you look closely, the traditional badge is gone and now etched into the panel of the car, which I think makes it easier to reuse and also recycle. If you check the interiors, although we do not have closer access than this, there are textile in contrast looking colors. There are three main pillars to the interior. You have the newly redesigned multifunctional steering wheel, which now houses the drive system. You have the panoramic vision display and also the central display screen. Interestingly, the vital information the driver needs is now projected into the windshield, which affords the complete design or redesign of the steering wheel without obstructing the driver's field of view. And you could practically now personalize the panoramic vision screen by just dragging widgets from the central display up to the panoramic vision. And again, the personalization can be linked to your driving profile, so you don't necessarily have to set it again each time you get into the car. Peradventure, you share the car with other people.
So the BMW panoramic vision really sets the stage for personalization. You can make it truly your own by selecting your preferred set of widgets. Just pick an app, media, weather, whatever you like, and drag it from the central display up to the panoramic vision. You configure your preferences for up to 6 widgets here. These will be linked to your driver profile, the BMW ID. And just like in Vegas, there are tons of options.
The Neue Klasse cars will use BMW's 6th generation lithium-ion batteries and 75, 90 and 105 kilowatt hours battery capacity. So range, thermal efficiency and charging times are all said to be around 30% improved on the current setup, which technically means that 300 kilometers of range can be recharged within 10 minutes. And again, BMW aims to reduce the car's carbon footprint by adopting production processes that conserve resources. So in terms of aerodynamics, the Neue Klasse X has aerodynamic drag reduced by 20% compared to the corresponding model lineup thanks to the new tire design. Production is set to kickstart in late 2025 and will be built in an entirely fossil fuel-free factory. So from what we know so far, although this has not been independently confirmed by BMW, a price tag of about £65,000 is expected. Traditional ECUs suffer from time lag, usually between 10 to 20 milliseconds, and this is one of the key advantages one supercomputer has over several sub-processors. So, in a nutshell, the supercomputer aims to eradicate time lag. For instance, when you interact with any of the features, the responses or the output you get will be highly responsive. Equally, the BMW Neue Klasse Saloon has an overall appearance that is dominated by large surfaces, clear lines, and the highly controversial design position of the car rear light. So, just like the design language you see on the Neue Klasse X, like the lowered belt line, the interactive grille with lights, and also the edged badge and so on, the Neue Klasse Saloon mimics the redefinition of BMW's future design path. The BMW Vision Neue Klasse will be controlled by BMW's new supercomputer nicknamed Heart of Joy. The powertrain and all the dynamic functions, including the braking, stability, and traction control systems, will be controlled by a single electric brain instead of several subcomputers, thanks to the combination of hardware and software. The German automaker BMW is well aware that a new audience is developing in the brave new world. Customers that desire mobile technologies and connectivity. Everyone longs for the emotional bond that only a well-maintained vehicle can provide. There are indications that this Neue Klasse vehicles will fulfill that promise. Additionally, cars with combustion engines will continue to be accessible. The question is, how long?
Give it to me.
Thanks for watching, and let me know if you think BMW has lost touch with its heritage or is on the positive path to define its legendary heritage.